Over the past 3 years, my life has been turned upside down.
It is a geopolitical legal saga that began back in December 2018, when Meng Wanzhou was arrested in Canada at the request of the United States, which sought to extradite her on fraud charges and lying as CFO of Huawei about dealings with Iran despite U.S. sanctions. But then on Friday, after years of wrangling, the Huawei heiress entered a Vancouver court for the seal of approval on a deal reached with federal prosecutors. The agreement states that charges will be dropped next year if Meng complies with admitting some wrongdoing. Before cameras, the 49-year-old celebrated the end of her house arrest in her multi-million dollar homes.
I will never forget all the good wishes I've received from people around the world.
About an hour after Meng's plane left for China, Canada's prime minister announced the release of Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig. The two Canadians had been arrested over 1,000 days earlier on charges of espionage, just after Meng's arrest, in what many countries have called hostage politics.
We have worked tirelessly for the past 2.5 years to get them home. I want to once again highlight the incredible work done by so many.
Over the years, the arrests had become symbols of Cold War-like animosity between the U.S. and China over trade and tech dominance. And the triple release has removed at least one thorn in the side of diplomatic and trade relations between China, Canada, and the U.S.
We'll take you back to that.